Dr. Stephen Pine. So today we are going to recapitulate the history chapter, that is Women and Reform. Yes, this we have already revised also, and we have learnt already about this chapter in your class. Okay. So today we are going to recapitulate the chapter Women and Reform from your history part. Okay, children. So in this chapter we have learnt about what were the conditions of women during the medieval period. How was the condition? What is the status of the woman? Okay. And even along with that, we have learnt about the social reformers, the different social reformers, the various social reformers who fought against these all, even practices which are prevalent in our Indian society. Yes, children. Okay, so first of all, just I'll give you the introduction about the chapter. Okay, so the reform movement of 19th century ushered in the age of education development. Okay, it means so many reforms, just we have learned about the Raja Ramohan Roy and even V.H. Lingam Pantulu, Savitribai Phule, Jyotiba Phule, okay, and even like Ishwarchand Vidyasagar. So these all are the reformers who fought against the evil practices which are there in our society, such as Purda, child marriage, Sati system, okay. These all were the evil practices which were prevalent in our Indian society. And some of the reformers, such as Raja Ramohan Roy, Ishwarchand Vidyasagar, these all, they raised their voice against this system, and they encouraged the child remarriage, and they fought against the evil practice, just Sati system, Purda system, child marriage. Okay, and they started, they gave encouragement to the education of the women, and even they gave encouragement, they started so many movements against the, to stop the child marriage, and even for the widow remarriage. Okay, children. So here, we'll recap the chapter now. First, we'll go with the one mark question answers. So here are some object type of questions. Okay, so let's move on for the one mark question. So first question is, practice of sati was abolished by, it is in the form of MCQ. Okay, children. I said section A will be containing 1 to 20 questions. It will be having 1 marks for each. So if these 20 questions can be in the form of MCQs, fill in the blanks, true or false, or even in the form of question and answer. So here I have given you some example for the 1 mark question, children. So first question is, the practice of sati was abolished by. See, children, it is given in the form of MCQ. So here you have to just choose the correct answer for the question. So question, the practice of sati was abolished by. Options are Lord William Bentinck, Lord Dalhousie, Lord Cornwallis, Lord Warren Hastings. Okay, so these are the four options. So what is the correct answer, children? Who is the Governor General who stopped the practice of sati? Yes, the correct answer is Lord William Bentinck. So here we mark this answer. Okay, children. So Lord William Bentinck is a person or the Governor General of India who stopped, who abolished the practice of sati. Okay, so next question. Who was the first Indian woman to become a doctor? This you have learned in the chapter. I repeat once again. Who was the first Indian woman to become a doctor? So answer is, children, see here, it is given the one mark question. Okay, it is in the form of question and answer. So here you have to write the answer in complete sentence. No options will be given. So answer is Anibai Joshi. Yes, the first Indian woman to become a doctor was Anibai Joshi. She was the first person, first woman who studied and who became a doctor in our Indian society. So next question for the one mark. Who founded the Brahma Samaj? Means who was the founder? Who established the Brahma Samaj? Okay, children. As you all know, yes, Raja Ramohan Roy was the first person to raise his voice against the sati system, and for the to stop this evil practice, he established, he organized a institution that is called a samaj, that is called as Brahma Samaj. So the Brahma Samaj was founded by Raja Ramohan Roy. Okay, you should write it in a complete sentence, children. Here is, I have written the answer, but you should write it in a complete sentence. So answer is, Raja Ramohan Roy was the founder of Brahma Samaj, or you can write Raja Ramohan Roy founded the Brahma Samaj. Okay, children. So this is about third question. Next, one more question for one mark. Mention any four evil practices, or mention any four evils of 19th century in India or Indian society also. You can say like that. So answer, which are the four evil practices, or which are the four evils during the 19th century in India? Yes, the answer, Purda system. What is the Purda system, children? means covering their whole body with a scarf, means covering their head, do not showing their face to anyone. That is called as purdah system. Polygamy. Polygamy is what? Having more than one wife. That system is called as purdah system. Sati system, it means burning wife alive with her husband's fire, or burning a woman on the husband's fire. That is called as sati system. And even the child marriage. Okay, so these all are the evil practices which were present in our Indian society during 19th century. I repeat the answer once again. Purdah system, child marriage, sati system and polygamy. These are the four evil practices of our Indian society during 19th century. Next, move on to the 3-mark question. Okay, see here. So, I have just written one answer as example for your confirmation for the 3-mark question. Okay, so see here, what was the contribution of Raja Ram Mohan Roy in women reform? Means, what is his contribution? Who? Raja Ram Mohan. How he fought against these all evil practices? Okay, so that they have asked here. Here it is asked for 3 marks. So we are going to write 3 points for the answer. In the answer. So see here children. First point, Raja Ram Mohan Roy wanted women to acquire a respectable status in the society. First aim to establish in the Brahma Samaj. What is that? According to Raja Ram Mohan Roy, every woman should get equal respect, equal status in the society. Next, he founded Brahma Samaj by which he condemned a sati system, purdah system, and he opposed child marriage and even the polygamy. Means after establishing or after finding organizing Brahma Samaj, what he did, he condemned, he opposed all the evil practices which were there in the Indian society, such as purdah system or the sati system, even child marriage and polygamy. Okay, by establishing the Brahma Samaj. Okay, this is the second point. Third point, he led movement of widow remarriage. Means that time they thought when a husband died, so woman should lead a very miserable life. So they were not allowed to remarry. So first, he led the movement for widow remarriage. Who? Raja Ram Mohan Roy. And he also gave momentum to the movements. It means he started or he began the movements against child marriage and even the polygamy. Polygamy is what? The person who is having more than one wife. Okay, so these all are the contribution of Raja Ram Mohan Roy for the woman reform. Means to change the status of a woman in an Indian society. This is about 3 marks. Now, I will read out some questions which can be asked for 5 marks. That is long answer. Okay. And one more thing children, don't forget to mention the question number correctly before attending any answer, before writing any answer. Okay. So, here are some questions for 5 marks children. See here. How did the reform movement help women? These all reform movements we have learned, such as it can be about like Raja Ram Mohan Roy or Ishwar Vidyasagar, who started so many education societies in or schools. Okay, and even like Dayanand Saraswati, the founder of Arya Samaj. Okay, and even the Kandapuri Vijayalingam Panthulu. These all the reformers who led struggle, who started so many movements to fight against the status of a woman. Okay, so here is the question: how did the reform movement help women? The reform movement had contributed to educate the women. First point for this question, that is 5 marks. So we are don't forget to write 5 points. You have to write the answer always in points. Okay, children. So the first point, the reform movements had contributed to educate the women. First, they thought that women should get educated. Okay. Then next point, many social evils which were prevailing in the society were abolished, like sati pratha, child marriage, polygamy, etc. So, second point, that means these all reformers thought these all social evil practices for their society should be stopped by the various laws enacted by the government. Means the government should implement some laws which should be against these all. Okay. Next is, women became active members of social groups and national movements when they got educated. they started to become the members of social groups, and even the they started to take part in the national movement. This is the third point. Fourth point, various issues like health and care, child welfare, right to vote, discrimination against the women were raised, and finally they became successful. Fifth point, now women are active members of the society. See children, so these all are the reform movements which help a woman to get the equal status in society or to get the respectable place in the society, we can say. Okay, so this is there for 5 marks. So this is all about the 5 mark, 3 mark and 1 mark question from this chapter. I hope you got my point clearly, children. And please don't forget to read the chapter, because 1 mark or even the passages can be given from the textbook. I hope you all are doing well. Have a great day ahead.